Okay, finally I would like to show you what we've done so far. Well, here we have the X-Wing. Well, it's not finished of course, but this beautiful mess I've made are all the 14 cables which have been glued with a hot gun so that they won't short circuit. All the power cable, sorry, all the lights are now functioning. Here goes the, and these are the landing gear lights, the red and green anti-collision lights, the engines, which you can see are flame LEDs, the landing lights for them. Here's the X-Wing. It's, as you can see, glued up, and it has received its share of pre-shades and its base coat. Now there's a few minor gaps I need to clear up over here. As you can see, I've used masking tape for the edges, and then I used normal sticky tape and scrap paper because otherwise if I would plastered full of masking tape, it will be very expensive. I used to use a standard sticking tape for masking, and that didn't work because the glue of the sticking tape, normal sticky tape, remained on a model. So now I use masking tape. I use Tamiya masking tape, and it gives the best effects. These panels over here, and there'll be a few panels in the back, but they'll be done later, are going to be a different color later on. What I'm going to do first, I'm going to spray them in a darker gray, and after that I'm going to put some water on it when it's dry, and put some water on it and coarse sea salt, and then respray it again in the original color, which is now, and hopefully the technique will pay off as it will look like it's corroded metal. coarse sea salt, a bit too coarse. So I've been using a pestle, made a bit less coarse. Then I'm going to take a clean paintbrush, some water. I'm going to gently put some water. Oh, well, I forgot this one. Oh, well, never mind. Some water over it. And then I'm going to sprinkle some of that salt over it. Can you see it? Yeah, maybe you're not. Okay. And I'll try to put more on the sides and on the edges. The idea is that as soon as the water has dried and the salt has remained on, I will spray it with the original color of the X-Wing. And when that's dry, I'm going to try to brush off the salt with a clean dry brush, like a toothbrush. Okay, let's see. Can you see it? Okay, let's see what happens if I try to brush away the salt. Here you can see a little bit, look like it's damaged paint. Let's see what happens. I try to brush it off over here. That's better. I'm not too sure if it has worked. That's a little bit better. It's not perfect, but better. And the last panel. Well, don't know. Not overly convinced. Now this looks much better. See? This looks much better. I'm not quite sure what I did different here as compared to the other sections, but this looks better. So, I have now completed two layers of red and a very small or very slight hint of orange on the top of the hull. And when it's dry, we're going to peel off the masking tape, and after that we're going to peel off or going to scrape off the salt, which, as you might be seeing, is on the maybe I'm gonna use another layer. I think I could use another layer of red. It's been not bright enough. Now I use another third layer of red, and then I'm gonna peel off the masking tape, and then scrape off the sand, and let's see if it has worked.